In this tutorial, I will talk about cross-site request forgery attack, and I'm going to show you how you can protect your forms by using some simple hash functions in PHP. Hey, what's up guys? Senaid here from quantypassiveincome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So, if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. Now, for some of you that don't know, cross-site request forgery is an attack where a malicious website will send a request to a web application that a user is already authenticated from a very different website. This way, an attacker can access functionality in a target web application via the victim's already authenticated browser. Targets include web applications like social media, in-browser email clients, online banking, and web interfaces for network devices. This is a very simple explanation, and I hope so that this explanation will give you the basic understanding what is cross-site request forgery. Now, let me show you how to implement protection in PHP. So now I'm here at my Sublime Text and I just created the normal index.php file. So as you can see, first we need to define some PHP code and I'm going to write here what we need to do. So first thing that we need to do is we need to start a session. After that, we need to create a key or hash admec function. After that, we need to create CSRFI token. And the last thing that we need to do is we need to accept the information from the form that we will create in HTML and validate the token. So we need to validate the token. Okay, so I'm going just to create some basic HTML form, nothing special. Okay, so I will say here form, method will be post, and action will be index.php, which is this same file. So we'll just have one input, type will be text, name will be username, and the placeholder will be what is your name. Very simple. We will have one hidden button where we will store our CSRFI token. Okay, and we will have one submit button. Okay, so this is one very simple HTML form. Let's now just see. So as you can see, we have two inputs. One is hidden, one is type text, and when you press submit, nothing happens. You should already know this. So now we need to start our session. Okay. After that, we want to see, do we have already created our session? So if we are not, we will create new key that we will use for hash admec function. And I'm going to create by calling two functions. First, binary to hex, and there I'll use random bytes and I'll use 32. So as you can see, this function will create 32 random bytes and this one will convert that bytes into the hex format. So we can see what we got by using this. Okay. That's it, and we are saving this hash into the session because we want to be sure that our key is always the same, or otherwise we won't be able to validate our CSRFI token that is inside the form. Okay, now the next thing is we need to create our CSRFI token. We will do that by doing by calling hash hmac function. The type of the encryption that I prefer to use is 256. For the data, we can write any type of the string, but what I usually do is I'll write some string, and at the end of that string I will append the name of the current file. That helps me so that if I have 10 different files, on every file I will have a different CSRFI token. So that way we have protected each time on the different way our form. So I'll write here, this is some string, and I will say index.php. And we have created the key, it's stored inside the session. We will just say key. And down below, we need to output this CSRFI token. Echo CCRFI. Let's now test. We check this. As you can see here, we have our CSRFI token, which is a very long token, and it's almost not possible to guess this string because we are using some very powerful functions that are available only in the PHP 7 version. So the next thing is we need to validate token. So first thing is we are going to do is if set post submit, which means this part of the code here will execute only if this button is pressed. So here we need to verify our token. I can do something like this, CSRFI equal post CSRFI, but that is not good enough protection. So I want to do and show you some better way, which I will use the function hash equals, and we will compare those tokens. We will say here, okay, we will just do something here, echo your name is token failed. Okay, so now let's test this. Refresh. Okay. Now let's say here. Okay, and submit. Your name is Senaid, which means that our CSRFI token is validated. But if we manipulate this token and put something here that is not correct, let's say like this, and try to submit, okay, CSRFI token failed. And as you can see, if we don't have the correct CSRFI token, we will never execute this part of the code, which is extremely important, and on this way our form is protected. So guys, I hope so that this is very simple tutorial and there really isn't a lot to learn. So just you need to learn how to properly create your key and also how to create the proper hash and validate that hash. So there are just four different functions that you need to know. So if you guys like this video, please like it and share it to your friends. And also if you have any question, I will be more than happy to answer it in the comments below. Take care.